Welcome to the Goose Riot Bad Movie Podcast. My name's Mike. This is episode 19, and we are doing Never Drum on a White Lady's Boobies at a Redneck Dance.
But we're doing Wild Wild West.
Yeah, whatever.
Yeah, whatever. It's the same.
That's the name of the movie. It's Never Drum on a White Lady's Boobies at a big Redneck Dance.
God, this movie was bad.
I loved it.
Did you really?
So bad.
Yeah.
I enjoyed the shit out of it, too.
How could you not like it? It had your favorite thing, a big black cock in it. How is that not good enough for you?
We're going to go and get that out of the way right
just
now.
Just a reminder, we watched Jack and Jill last time.
Yeah. No.
That Jack and Jill didn't have BBC in it, though.
But you can't. No.
It did have Adam Sandler's little Jewish cut penis.
Did it?
Yeah. It wasn't in the movie, but it was. Everyone saw his dick while they were filming it.
Meh.
That's true, actually. That was
he was wearing a skirt. Yeah. It flopped out.
Let's be honest.
It flopped out.
It probably flops the wrong word. It implies size.
And this is where we get sued by Adam Sandler. But yeah, we're going to go and get this out of the way. At one point in this movie, you actually see Will Smith's D.
D, really?
Yes.
I sent you that earlier today.
Yeah.
In that picture. What did you think that was?
Was it actually
not a
in there?
Clear-cut
yeah.
Dick pic.
It's pretty much a dick pic.
You can
see
his peaches with little fuzz on them.
No, you see an uncut dick.
You know how I know you're gay? You called him peaches.
Yeah, why did you call him peaches?
Okay, that's not okay.
So we're going to go ahead.
They weren't fucking watermelons.
We're going to introduce everybody, starting to my left.
I'm Todd.
I'm here too. I'm Zach.
Gilbert.
Holy crap, that's Will Smith's dick. I'm Tanner.
I'm a fucking Chad Lion.
Are you?
Sir. H-N-I-C.
Sir Chad Lion.
Sir Chad Lion, H-N-I-C.
Okay. What does that stand for?
I can't say it. I'm forbidden.
So we're going to go ahead and go to the movie synopsis and get this out of the way.
Yes, we are. But first, let's talk about something else while I pull it up.
Oh.
So, are you saying that you're not cut, Tanner?
Tanner, are you not cut?
No.
Hey, you're uncircumcised.
Of course not. I am extra cut. In fact, they took off a couple inches at birth because they were like, "This isn't
is
fair."
That what
it's,
happened?
It's not like the
it's not fair.
Okay. It's not like the league where it was like hidden, so they could only cut half of it.
Yeah, it was a botched circumcision. I have a Y dick actually, right down the middle. They made up.
I saw a picture of that the other day.
Did you really?
4chan.
You gotta love 4chan.
I do.
Did you guys ever see the
medical condition? You get
that hacker
data.
Has a
yeah.
website.
Yeah, the hacker 4chan.
Yeah. Did you guys ever see the Reddit the Ask Me Anything of the guy with two dicks?
Yep.
Yes.
I did.
That was
one of my favorite
AMAs. Guy had two dicks.
He's come out again and like done like actual like not just AMAs but like real interviews with it and stuff. And it, I mean, it's
real interviews with it. So dick. Left.
No, I think he did one for like Hustler or something.
Yeah. No, he just did like real interviews about it and. Had pictures taken and showed that like it's functional,
mm-hmm.
but only partially. He couldn't get them both hard at the same time. He said, "Like
I thought like one of them was completely functional.
It's
the
like,
other one's like halfsies.
It's like one of those water spigots. You turn one side on, you turn the other side on. You'll turn both of them on.
How do you control which one does it that time though?
One's always a little bit.
You just squeeze one nut, left or right.
I assume he has at least three nuts too.
No, just two. No man needs more than two. Unless you're Tom Green.
What if he had
wish
two
for a
dicks
surplus?
And no, two dicks, no nuts. Just the two dicks there. I'd take that.
Diphalia. That's the medical condition.
Oh, thank you.
Shut up.
Wonderful.
All right, on to the plot synopsis now that I've got it pulled up. Oh, good. We get to see pictures of two dicks. Sweet.
This is awful.
Starting in a small section of the near south, both Captain James West and Marshal Artemis Gordon hunt for General Bloodbath McGrath, who was wanted for mass murder. Points back to when McGrath ordered a massacre in a settlement called New Liberty, where many of the freed slaves were murdered, including West's biological parents. The search leads to a brothel, where the two try, unsuccessfully, to arrest him. It leads to a huge brawl and a cart of nitroglycerin crashing into the building that starts a fire. Both West and Gordon, the latter dressed as a woman, escape later in Washington, D.C., West and Gordon meet at the White House with President Ulysses S. Grant, who tells them about the disappearance of America's key scientists in a treasonous plot by General Bloodbath McGrath. Grant charges the two with finding the scientists before he inaugurates the first transcontinental railroad at Promontory, Utah. On board the train, Gordon examines the head of a murdered scientist and uses projection device to reveal the last thing the scientist saw. Finding McGrath and a clue in the image, they head to New Orleans to pursue a lead about Dr. Arliss Loveless, an ex-Confederate scientist in a steam-powered wheelchair who is hosting a party for the elite of Southern society. Wes mistakes a female guest for a disguised Gordon and makes an error that results in the guest wanting to lynch Wes.
The error is slapping the fat chick's boobies.
Yeah, hence the title.
Yep.
Meanwhile, Gordon roams the mansion and comes across a cage Rita Escobar, which is played by Selma Hayek. Is that her?
Yep, yes. Super fucking hot.
Mm-hmm. And he rescues her. Gordon frees Wes from the lynching with an elastic rope, and the three escape to their train, the Wanderer. On board, Rita asks for help in rescuing her father, one of the kidnapped scientists, Professor Escobar. Later, Loveless hosts a reception to demonstrate his newest weapon, a steam-powered tank. The tank uses General McGrath's soldiers as a target practice, which angers McGrath. When McGrath demands an explanation, Loveless shoots him and leaves him for dead. As Loveless and his troops head over to Utah, Gordon, Wes, and Rita find the dying McGrath, who reveals he was framed by Loveless for the massacre of New Liberty, explaining that Loveless used the tank to kill the people there. Gordon, Wes, and Rita then pursue Loveless on the Wanderer, but having expected their arrival and using steam-powered hydraulics, Loveless maneuvers his train behind the Wanderer. Wes manages to disable Loveless's train, but not before Loveless uses a cannon launching grappling hook to stop the Wanderer. Rita, afraid of being recaptured by Loveless, grabs one of Gordon's explosive rigged pool balls and accidentally releases sleeping gas that knocks out Wes, Gordon, and herself. Wes and Gordon wake up as Loveless and his posse pull away in the Wanderer, taking Rita hostage, announcing that he intends to capture President Grant at the Golden Spike ceremony, and also that should Wes and Gordon step outside of the trap, they will likely be killed. Escaping the trap, the two stumble across Loveless's private rail line, which leads them to his industrial complex hidden in Spider Canyon. Here they witness Loveless's ultimate weapon, a gigantic mechanical spider armed with two nitroglycerin cannons. Loveless uses the spider to capture President Grant and Gordon at the ceremony and Promontory Point, while Wes is seemingly shot by one of Loveless's bodyguards. At his industrial complex, Loveless reveals a plan to destroy the United States with his mechanized forces, unless President Grant agrees to divide the states among Great Britain, France, Spain, Mexico, and himself. Loveless demands that President Grant surrender, but he refuses. Loveless then tries to have Gordon shot in the head if Grant still refuses to surrender. But Wes, who had survived thanks to the chainmail vest that that Gordon invented. What the hell?
You want me to just end it?
Yeah, go for it.
They all fight. They get rid of the bad guy, and then they drive off into the sunset in the giant spider.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah. Typical Wild Wild West movie.
So take my boredom during that 3-minute explanation and extrapolate it to 2 hours, and it's a pretty good representation of that movie.
I was actually surprised there was that much plot to it.
Yeah, I mean, I still had like 4 paragraphs left.
I don't remember that much going on there.
Because you were so fucking bored.
All
that
I remember
you didn't
is
know what's happening.
Sorry. All I remember is Selma Hayek's titties.
Oh, goddamn.
No
she
joke.
Was
yeah. In the little underwear, in the trap door.
Yeah, that ass.
That beehole.
For our listeners,
breast of Fred ass. Fresh
Selma
ass.
Hayek does not have pancake titties.
No.
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 She has doesn't. The opposite of pancake titties.
Who was arguing that pancake titty point? Was it Schmitz?
It was Schmitz.
What the fuck is wrong with that kid?
He's got one eye.
Yeah. Well,
it's the depth thing. You can't see how deep they
one
are.
One eye and a 16-inch dick. Apparently, you get a 16-inch dick, you'll fucking...
Well, he couldn't see the depth of the titties. Like,
there is no depth
sideways,
to the titties.
You know?
They all look like flapjacks to him.
Yeah, apparently.
He sees life in 2D.
Yeah, I don't... So, Selma Hayek was in this. Will Smith was in this as the main lead.
Captain James West.
Yes.
Jim
Kevin
West.
Klein was the supporting
Loveless.
Actor.
Yes. Artemis,
oh, no,
Gordon.
Artemis Gordon. Yeah.
And the president.
Who played Loveless?
That was Kenneth Branagh.
He's
he was
dude
in Valkyrie.
From
I don't know what else he's been
Jack
in.
Ryan.
That Tom Cruise movie.
Yeah, Jack Ryan.
Jack Ryan.
Another Tom Cruise movie.
And he had the weird
oh, no,
facial
that
hair. That facial hair was weird.
That facial hair
it
was
on
point.
It was baller. It was fucking baller.
It's like the a la Suvorov.
It was close, but no, there was no
it was,
a la Suvorov.
It was riff-raff-ish.
Oh, yeah, I could.
Yeah, I'll give you that.
Yeah.
But this movie, like, what the fuck were these people thinking when they wrote about how magnets, like when they read about how magnets work?
I have no idea, and that really bothered me.
I feel like magnets are pretty simple.
I learned a lot. You know?
Did you?
If you hit a magnet with a rock, it reverses its polarity.
That's
everyone
how,
knows that.
That's science.
Yeah.
I learned that from the Insane Clown Posse, actually.
No. That's a good place to learn things.
Wu-Tang taught me. They taught me that and about the streets.
I heard they're nothing to fuck with.
They are not.
I saw an 18-year-old girl with a Wu-Tang symbol tattooed under her
foot
the other day.
Oh,
it bothered me.
I saw one have a tramp stamp, a Wu-Tang tramp stamp before.
Hold on. You say it's under her foot?
It was on her foot, like, on the top of her
foot. Oh, I think it's under
her foot. Did you slap her and
by
say,
her age?
It was the age that got me. It was just like, you were like 2.
Did you know about Wu-Tang?
Me liking Wu-Tang is a stretch.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I'm a 28-year-old man, so.
Yeah, Wu-Tang still got groupies. What's up with that?
Child.
That's weird. What else about the movie?
There were other people in it, like his 4 lovely ladies.
There were a lot of people.
What the fuck?
What?
Magnets. I'm still fucking stressing over the magnets.
All right, let's talk about the
magnets. I thought about that for like fucking 30 minutes of that movie with just the stupid-ass magnets.
What about the weird floating saws?
I didn't understand.
Yeah.
They were magnetic.
They were magnetic.
That was supposed to be the explanation, is that they were attracted to the magnets.
But
you could dodge them.
That's not how magnets and metal work. If it goes past you, it would just continue going
right.
If it had momentum.
I agree.
Yeah.
And if they hit each other, it explodes.
Yeah,
everyone knows that magnetic items explode when they hit each other.
Also, if they came in from above, they wouldn't.
It's in the Bible.
They would just get stuck in there and not go through the neck like it was supposed to.
Yeah. Actually, I think that was 1 Corinthians.
1 Corinthians.
Magnets that strike each other explode.
It was Egyptians.
Yeah, it could have been Egyptians.
Egyptians, Chad.
It was a good book.
You know what else bothered me? When the guy got his head cut off and they. Somehow the image you see when you die is burned into your retinas.
That's bad for you, Tanner, huh?
What?
We should test it on you. It's going to be your dick.
You're gonna
I hope I see my dick while I'm dying.
I thought that was a rape joke. like they can just extrapolate the last image from all the girls Tanner's raped and murdered.
I have not murdered anybody. All right?
They all died on accident. Okay?
What about that one?
Gravity killed them.
No,
not me.
What about the lady boy? Are you kind of the lady boy or not kind of the lady
boy?
I still have her tied up. Him. Her.
It. She.
Yeah.
Just it.
So the creepy ass ear. Or lack thereof.
That dripped like
on Buffalo Bill.
It literally looked like a cow pie. It looked like shit on the side of his head with a horn stuck into the side of it. I didn't understand it.
The dripped.
You wanted to fuck it, didn't you?
A little bit.
I was just waiting for him to force people to put lotion on.
Is it the same guy?
Yeah.
Yeah. General Bloodbath McGrath.
Bloodbath.
Bloodbath.
I love how he just dumped his ear like on his own clothes. Like didn't even try and dump it on the ground or anything.
It's a different
day. He was trying to fuck the dude that was dressed as a prostitute at the beginning. I don't think he fucking cares.
Kevin Klein looked awful. Awful. Like most dudes would look awful as a woman, but I think he looked fucking
bad. Especially bad.
Was that the
purpose, though? His nose was so Jewy.
I feel like they purposely put a bunch of ugly prostitutes in that scene just to make up for it.
They were so gross.
They were disgusting.
Selma Hayek, I think they did it to accentuate Selma Hayek was what it was, not him.
Yeah.
That.
Yeah.
Because she was fucking a rose among the rest of them.
What's funny is that was probably the only authentic piece to the time. It's like, oh yeah, the hookers were gross.
Yeah.
So were all the other women back then.
They were all worn down pretty bad.
Yeah. Desert life's rough. By the way, did people actually wear all those vests and the shirts and the all that
seems
stuff?
Really cumbersome, doesn't it?
Well, it would be hot.
Yeah.
No, they did. They wore all that stuff.
There's a reason they wear the big baggy clothing, you know, in other parts of the world where it's all deserty.
We're talking about MC Hammer?
What?
Can't touch this.
No.
There's a reason deodorant was invented, too.
Yeah.
So
hippies don't have to use it.
Did anybody else have a problem with the historical facts being off?
I wasn't really paying attention to that in this movie.
The fact that the Capitol building was still under construction?
Really?
Yeah, that one, it threw me off. It doesn't make sense to me.
That was not something that I was...
You did? Okay. Maybe it was just me.
Yeah.
I just saw random,
that did
like...
not make or break this movie for me.
It definitely...
My favorite part was they were trying to figure out why Will Smith was just, you know, traipsing into the White House. Like, what is this black dude doing in here?
Oh, he's got a gun. Let him go.
Everyone knows that's how you get into the White House.
What about him having sex in a fucking water tower? How rude is that?
Yeah, that's like, an entire city's water supply.
That's a dick move.
What a dick.
No pun intended.
And that's right after that. You see his dick, so it's perfect.
I still can't believe it showed dick.
I know. PG-13 for you.
Yeah. Well, it's Will Smith dick. He's a Fresh Prince. It's
it was probably like a rope or something they just had dangling there for dick effect.
Dick effect. I forgot about the dick effect. That's one of those...
They hired a consultant. Like, so we're trying to figure out how to get a dick effect in this movie without actually showing a dick.
I mean, you just figure Will Smith is probably more endowed than that.
And they like showed up
be
with
hanging
like
down half knee.
They showed up with like 30 options.
Have you seen the kids he produced effects with that dick? I'm telling you, the fruit's gone bad.
Hey, it was cold. He was he was in the water tower. It was cold. Get off him.
What was it? He said After Earth was his worst like career.
He said this movie because he turned it. He turned down The Matrix for this movie. He said that was his worst career decision.
He probably said that a while ago, though.
He did. And then he said After Earth, the movie he did with his own son. He's like, that was my biggest failure.
Yeah, but it's not. I don't think it was because he did it with his son, though, because, I mean, he did. He had a couple movies that he did with his son.
Really?
Yeah.
Pursuit of Happiness?
Yeah, Pursuit of Happiness. Well, that was 7 Pounds, I think it was called.
7 Pounds was fucking terrible, though.
I hated 7
That's
Pounds.
That's when his kid was too young to have a personality. As soon as he developed his own personality and turned into a shithead.
Shut your fucking mouth.
As soon as he started.
Have you read his
Jackie
Twitter?
Chan.
Yeah.
He's like God. He's like the second coming of Christ.
He's
Black Jesus. He's full black Jesus. He just doesn't look full black.
Is he? Yeah, Jada's not full black.
What is Jada?
She's pretty light.
Jada's fucking hot.
Would you fuck
Jada? She was.
Hashtag I would fuck Jada Pinkett Smith.
She was.
That will probably be a hashtag for this episode on Twitter.
Would it really?
Why not?
Yeah. All right. Fair enough.
It doesn't show up on iTunes. I can put whatever the fuck I want in the hashtags.
the hashtags have nothing to do with Selma Hayek. I would totally fuck her.
Yes, but Jada Pinkett Smith too.
How does she age? Is she still all right?
I don't know.
She's still pretty hot.
I mean, it's been a couple of years.
What is y'all's favorite Selma Hayek movie?
Desperado. Didn't Desperado have titties in it?
I don't know that they were her titties though. Dogma.
Dogma's solid. I haven't watched Dogma in a long time.
It's a good movie.
You know who is way hotter than her in Dogma though? Alanis Morissette.
You're fucking out of your goddamn mind.
At one point, she goes almost full frontal.
If you could pick any hot Jew, why would you pick her?
Dogma. I wouldn't. I'd pick Sarah Silverman.
Oh, yeah. For me, it's Lizzie Kaplan.
Yeah,
but no, favorite Selma Hayek movie?
Dogma.
I'll go with Dogma.
No, From Dusk Till Dawn.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know I had the answer
I'm
going
to go Here Comes the Boom.
I didn't know there was a right answer to this.
No, because your answer is not nearly as wrong as that one.
Wait, what was it?
Here Comes the Boom. What?
I don't even remember that movie.
Do you know what she looks like in From Dusk Till Dawn?
I did that mainly to piss you off.
She had a snake. She danced around with nothing but a snake on.
Snakes creep me out.
Oh my God.
So do clowns.
God, I want to call you bad things.
I'm going to have to go Grown Ups 2. Grown Ups 2 was definitely the best piece of work she's ever done.
It's a doozy.
I didn't mean her. Like, I meant her body. I didn't mean her. Who gives
a
fuck?
Yeah, you
go
with the earlier
about
words.
Her acting.
Then I'm going Frida on that one. Then with her body.
I don't even know what that is.
I don't either.
Like Drew Barrymore and E.T.
They put the unibrow on, right?
Yeah,
she might have been five with that mouth
18.
Oh gosh. Thanks, my
Barney.
Goodness.
Just because I mentioned Drew Barrymore, does it bother any of you guys that she only looks mildly attractive under certain lights and the other ones she's absolutely hideous under?
I absolutely think she's disgusting.
Can you show me these mildly attractive pictures?
She doesn't look bad until you see the droop on her mouth. Like, when you start seeing that fucking side mouth shit, when you start seeing that side mouth shit, you just want to punch her and straighten it out.
Well, she did some, like, makeup commercials where she looked okay, but I feel like
Charlie's Angels. No, she looked good in Charlie's Angels.
No, she didn't.
And some of them.
You had Cameron Diaz and Lucy Liu to go beside her, and it made her look uglier.
Do you guys know Cameron Diaz did softcore porn?
Yeah, it wasn't good.
No.
It was just titties.
Yeah.
Well, it's softcore.
Yeah, that's what softcore is.
Well, I know, but it wasn't good. Like, it was like 1980s
like
softcore, so it wasn't
grunge porn.
Like, yeah.
So she was like 14?
Like, you can't even tell their titties because it's so pixelated.
So Wild Wild West, huh?
Huh?
Wild Wild West, huh?
No, tangents.
Moving on.
Tangents.
No, hold on. Whoa, we were just talking about something.
No one wants to talk about this movie.
What were we talking about before we went into Cameron Diaz? Lucy Liu. Lucy Liu is fucking hot.
We haven't talked about Charlie's Angels.
But she's a cunt.
Oh, I don't doubt that. She's Asian. She looks like a cunt. They
wow.
Yeah, you know that's pretty bad. I don't mean that way. I mean, I don't mean it like that.
And you know what? For the first time I can say this, we know we have Asian listeners.
Yeah. I don't care. No, she just has that chronic bitch face. You know what I mean?
She does. RBF.
Yeah, she does.
But like a lot of Asians like that look like Lucy Liu have that chronic bitch face. Like
name
if,
one that you know.
I don't know any other Asian actresses, so I can't name anyone.
So you're just going off of her.
I mean, I can name porn star Asa Akira. Asa Akira looks like she's a bitch too.
No.
Yeah, until she does some things, and then you're like, maybe she's all right.
Not U.S. shit name actors. You go straight for porn star.
Because I don't know any.
Sandra Oh.
Who the fuck is that? I don't know who the fuck that is.
Sideways.
Grey's Anatomy.
Never seen Sideways.
Jackie Chan.
She's just fucking gross.
Jackie Chan.
Yeah, but
Jackie Chan looks friendly. Like
Jackie Chan, I want to cuddle RBF with too. Him.
Most Asian dudes, no, most Asian dudes look like they would be your best friend.
Yeah,
like they do. Kim like Jackie Jung Chan, Il. Yeah, he does.
Yeah,
that guy looks like a fly motherfucker.
Did you see the interview?
You know,
I would hang out with him.
You know, he may be a deranged.
You know that, right?
Not
that's
it.
Oon.
That's Oon. First of all, I said ill.
How bad could his dad be?
Yeah, you know, you saw.
He was a horrible person.
You saw Team America. He was just lonely.
I'm sure.
His people love him so much that they're willing to starve to death while he lives a great life.
Hey,
I think that
that's
means
a good,
he's
I
a great
like
guy.
He's doing a good job too, but that's not the point.
But no,
here.
his son may be deranged, but have you seen his fade? You can't
fresh,
deny that that fade is fresh as fuck.
You know his barber is black.
Oh yeah, he's gotta be. You don't get a fade that good.
Dennis Rodman?
You know.
No, it's Dennis Rodman.
Actually,
barber,
that's probably why Dennis Rodman goes to North Korea. just to cut Kim Jong's hair. Yeah. I'm pretty sure that's the case. There's your next comic, Kim Jong.
I could do that. Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
Okay, so Wild West.
Is that what movie we're talking about? Wild West.
I believe so.
Okay. How do you think Kim Jong?
Really
How do you think Kim Jong Un likes Wild Wild West? I bet it's one of his favorite movies of all time.
This shit.
Yeah. Well, it just came out over there. So
no, his favorite movie is Space Jam.
Possibly
loves that shit.
Whose favorite movie isn't Space Jam?
Mine.
Really?
You're out of here.
Not my favorite.
Should be.
We should watch that. I'm adding it to the list.
Okay.
Okay. Wild Wild West. One thing that bothered me is the machine that shot the saws had a pumping dick on it for clearly no reason other than one little
force.
Joke.
It had to pump force out.
No.
It was
that how
it
you
was
pump
air.
Force out?
Yeah.
It was building up
I get
air.
Up and thrust.
Everything was pneumatic in this movie.
Yeah. Which, yeah. None of that is how science works.
I enjoyed the whole half-body wheelchair thing that he had going on there. It was super creepy, and I didn't understand how it worked.
Yeah.
I thought it was amazing. The fact that he that he was talking about how he'd still be able to pleasure a woman with no dick. Like
I'm assuming he's talking about mechanical dicks.
Obviously. What
okay,
else
haven't
about?
You ever had a night where you've drank a little too much and you have to start getting resourceful? I mean, there's other ways to go about it.
You're asking the wrong crap here.
No, that's true.
That's not true. Just because I'm by myself doesn't mean I can't get resourceful.
He gets a little drunk. He's got to make his hand feel good.
Yeah. I don't know if Big Black Dildo was that resourceful.
No. I get resourceful. I pull up Tanner's sister on Facebook.
Oh,
oh
gosh,
it's
that's
a little
gross.
Droopy.
Gets half of my dick really hard.
That's so wrong.
For the other half, I go for his mom.
I feel like that's a really, really poor pussy for someone who can't get hard.
Yeah.
Maybe that's what does it for me, though.
Inside jokes.
They'll get them sooner or later.
Yeah, probably. What else? This movie was not good. I don't have specifics.
The green screen in the desert?
Yeah.
That was such garbage.
Yeah, no, it there's just... Like it went by quickly, but not quick enough. Like the movie was short,
hour 45.
Here's another thing I kind of gotta wonder when the magnetic neck thing
really you're
flew,
back on this.
The mag
no it's part of this when it flew towards the train track his private track why was his private track half covered if he just traversed it.
Because he has a little machine that goes behind it.
There's brooms. There's brooms on the back of the train.
God. Steam powered brooms.
Yeah,
science, bitch.
Yeah,
apparently.
So this movie was based off an old TV show that
A very good TV show.
Yeah, that was pretty popular.
Well, sure.
And
it's called Wild Wild West.
And they tried to get the actor who was from the show that starred in the show to do a like a cameo. And the guy was so offended after reading the script that he's like, there's no way I'm going to have anything to do with it. And he hated the movie so much that when it won the Razzies, he went and accepted for the film.
Yes, he did.
Wow. I did not know that.
Yeah.
Some big names that were supposed to play parts in this movie when it first was
Vin Diesel.
Nope, Mel Gibson.
I would have watched that.
As James West and Richard Donner as Artemis Gordon.
Yeah, they wanted to do it back in 92.
Yeah, and then at one point it looked like George Clooney might have played Artemis Gordon too. But
oh, that would have been beautiful.
He turned it down.
Because George Clooney's beautiful.
Because it was a supporting part, not because the movie sucked.
Yeah.
But because it wasn't a main part.
George I read something different. He turned it down for Solaris.
Oh, my fucking God.
That's a great movie.
Don't
get me started on that stupid fucking movie.
Why are we watching that movie?
I don't want anything to ever do with that movie next week, Solaris.
You're outvoted.
Y'all's vote can go fuck yourselves.
I won't be here.
Yeah, I think I'm going to skip that week, too.
I'm going to throw AI in there as well. Just that's one of Miley's favorites.
Talking to himself.
Fuck that. Yeah, it's just Gil.
it's like the movie. Gilbert's it's very meta.
Uh-huh.
Special episode, Gilbert talks to himself about Solaris.
It's an hour-long monologue about fucking Solaris.
It's short. He's like, I actually kind of liked it.
It's just him reading the script.
Yeah, it actually takes off and becomes a big Broadway thing. Gilbert sitting on stage talking about Solaris.
And he leaves us all behind.
It's Left Behind 3.
Are they going to make another one with Nick Cage?
Oh, God.
Like, book two?
I hope so. The first one was so, so bad.
How bad did it flop in box?
I don't know. Like, I didn't look. It's out on DVD now, so.
Already?
Yeah, oh, it's been out.
They got my money.
Yeah. They just got mine, too. It was worth it.
Yeah, we paid.
It was worth it because it was so horrible.
Ugh. Is Nick Cage ever going to do a decent movie again?
What?
No.
I mean,
I thought you were gonna say he's never done a decent movie, no, and I was gonna jump across this fucking table.
He's done some decent movies. Con I mean, Sorcerer's Apprentice was fantastic.
The Rock,
Con fucking Air, National fucking Treasure.
National Treasure was probably the height of his career.
Was that was good?
Yeah, that was really good.
National Treasure is probably some of the greatest things that he's ever done.
We did Face Off, so
the first National Treasure wasn't actually that bad for what it was.
Oh no, I enjoyed it. They supposedly have 3 and 4 in the works right now.
I don't care about all that. I'm not watching that.
I'm reading his upcoming films. He's got one called The Runner, The Trust, Pay the Ghost, which I don't know what that's about.
Ghost Rider 3.
National Treasure 3, Men with No Fear, and The Croods 2. I didn't even know it was in Croods.
Yeah, I don't know.
Oh, man.
Wild Wild West, guys. We keep getting off track because this movie was that bad.
You know, I don't know that we've ever been on track in this podcast,
It's never been this bad. We've literally said four sentences
Doom
about this
was
movie.
Pretty bad. Doom was pretty... We got off track a lot in Doom. But
okay, let's...
I don't think people listen to us because they really want to hear about this movie.
I agree.
They should, though.
More about the getting off track for them than it is the movie.
Yeah.
Left Behind grossed $14 million.
What was the budget?
$400.
No, it probably wasn't very high, honestly.
Nick Cage bought about $10 million there.
I want to bring it back to something Chad just said that taken in a, like...
16.
Like... Not taken in context could have been really, really strange.
What did he say?
The getting off track is why people listen to us.
I get what you're saying.
That's one of the secret tracks.
Is this part of Gilbert's solo Solaris episode?
The getting off track. 3 minutes of him just breathing heavily until finally he grunts a little bit and rolls over and goes to sleep.
This movie, though, actually made a lot of money.
It didn't.
No, that's speculation.
It made a little bit over budget, and they think that...
That's speculation, though. It did make a lot of money.
They think the only reason this movie made money was because there were a bunch of unaccompanied minors buying tickets to this, because they could buy tickets because it was PG-13, and then sneaking in to South Park or American Pie.
Yeah.
But the budget was $170 million. It made $222 million. $52 million is a lot.
It still made money off of those tickets.
Yeah. Well, and the other thing was there, if I remember correctly, there was a huge promotion for this movie.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like I remember going and seeing this movie in theaters and being excited about it, and then getting into it and being like, "This is horrible."
Are you kidding me? I got out of that movie and I was jacked. I was like, "Oh fuck, that was Wild Wild West." The song alone was enough to get me hard.
The song
was half the marketing.
Let's go to the song. The song is the exact same beat.
Don't care.
And rhythm as the MIB song.
Don't care.
You could literally put the words of the MIB song into that and you'll get the same thing.
I understand that. Will Smith knew how to make a hit.
Obviously not.
He doesn't have that much free
time. They were hit songs.
He's got to multitask.
Both of the movie songs were hit songs.
Wild Wild West was not a hit song.
Yeah, at the time it was. It did well. I remember hearing it a lot.
Yeah, same with Men in Black.
Neither of these songs were as good as Getting Jiggy With It, though.
No, well,
or Miami.
Miami was good shit.
Yeah, that was my joint.
How does he have a career? Like, I mean, he seems like someone who's made all the wrong moves except Fresh Prince of Bel-Air,
Independence
fantastic
Day
show.
Because his grandma told him, don't cuss in your songs, and he didn't.
That's true.
Eminem does, though.
Yeah. Will Smith ain't got a cousin his raps.
Oh, God, it was a number one hit.
Yeah,
you.
I'm trying to think of other Will Smith movies that I was like, you know what? I like
look
that.
Up the MIB
I
song.
Robot wasn't Ollie. Awful.
I didn't like it, though.
I didn't like it,
yeah,
but
US
it was
Billboard
okay.
Hot 100 hit one.
Did you know that Drew Hill in
Ollie was
too?
Good, yeah.
Ollie was really
Ollie
good.
Was good.
I like The Pursuit of Happiness, too.
Yeah.
I wasn't a huge
Hitch,
fan.
Hitch was great.
Neither was I.
Hitch was pretty good.
What was
Hitch
that was one good. Movie he did in the city? I Am Legend? No. Was I Am
I
Legend?
Legend. I really enjoyed I Am Legend.
I thought it was horrible.
I heard the book was really good.
Yes, but I enjoyed I Am Legend for what it was.
It was him walking around talking to his dog for 2 hours.
The original.
Oh, it's like my life.
The original movie was supposed to be good.
No, he said talking, not fucking.
Oh.
This
sorry, Droopy. I'll be home later.
That's the same name I have for your sister's vagina.
You take
Oh my God. Zing. Australia, Men in Black was number one. Belgium, it was number one. Europe, number one. France, number one.
I already admitted that it was an
No, I'm talking about Men in Black now.
Oh, I don't care about that either.
Yeah.
I understand Men in Black was a big hit.
Anyone who is young
Wild
during
Wild
that
West.
Age remembers that soundtrack.
But it was the same song, so hey, it makes sense that it would
when,
do good the
that's what
time
I'm
around.
Saying. That's what I was saying, you know? He knows how to make hits.
We didn't even mention that. I did enjoy Men in Black, and Men in Black 3 was decent.
Yeah.
I like Josh Brolin. I mean,
I
haven't really seen many bad Josh Brolin movies. What was that movie where half of his face was missing?
Jonah Hex.
I like Jonah Hex. A lot of people didn't.
That movie was terrible.
That movie.
It was slightly entertaining. It was after everyone hated Megan Fox, including me.
It wasn't as bad as the flop that was Cowboys and Aliens.
Oh, God.
I wanted
that movie
to be so much better than it was.
Was weird.
It wasn't good. For it being Favreau and Daniel Craig, like I really expected it to be a lot better than it was.
That's all I can say about that movie.
Yeah.
It's like I watched it.
I was bored, honestly.
Yeah,
like,
it was
pretty bad.
For the kind of movie that it was, I wasn't expecting it to be that bad.
It was very stretched out and it wasn't a long movie.
Because I love Daniel Craig and I love Jon Favreau.
Yeah,
Jon Favreau's the shit.
Yeah.
I have nothing to say. Like, okay, so... We didn't mention that this movie was like 90% puns.
Yeah.
Like it was really racist and pretty sexist as well.
Boar's Head had its hands.
Yeah,
all
Boar's Head.
In this movie.
Boar's Head was pulling the strings here.
I can't get over the fact that he turned down The Matrix after reading this script.
For this.
Yeah, he's like, no, this
is
my
special
winner.
Effects whiz.
Yeah. You know, this was the most expensive movie made in, what was it, 99?
Yeah.
Yeah. Or no, 97. 97 or 99? 99. This was the most expensive movie made in 99.
It's still like one of the most expensive action movies made by, what is it, Fox or whoever made it.
Yeah.
It's still up there with one of the most expensive movies ever made from them.
They learned their lesson, apparently.
Yes,
I guess back then, I mean, there was a lot of CGI in this, and back then that was still pretty expensive.
Well, the effects were complete garbage compared to The Matrix, which he turned down.
Oh,
yes.
I love The Matrix.
I don't know. The effects in this movie were pretty good. I mean, for what they
that
were.
That green screen?
99?
The green screen wasn't great, but for 1999.
Okay, compare this
to The Matrix.
To The Matrix, which was the same time.
Yeah.
I mean,
what was the budget on The Matrix?
I don't know.
Less than this.
I don't think it was less.
I call bullshit
it's probably
on that.
Pretty close. That the bullet time sequences that they did in the Matrix were expensive.
Yeah, they were really expensive, but I don't care if he turned that movie down for this.
Yeah, I agree. It was bad on his part. But when you read a script, you can't really tell, you know, what the movie's going to turn out like. I mean, you can tell what the story's going to be like, which I agree, but, you know, who was willing to pay Will Smith more? That's probably what it boils down to.
Yeah. I just know that Keanu added another notch to his amazing, amazing career.
Amazing?
And...
Have you seen Point Break?
Will Smith.
Like, let's say they offered you,
Did you see 47 Ronin? Because no one else did.
I don't care about 47 Ronin. Like, I've enjoyed way more Keanu Reeves movies than I have Will Smith movies.
In 1999, if they offered you $20 million to do Wild Wild West and $10 million to do The Matrix, which one are you going to do?
He's already fucking rich. You do a good fucking
movie. In 99? He was coming off Fresh Prince, but that doesn't mean he was rich.
He was also coming off ID4.
I guess.
That made him a lot of money.
Doesn't matter, though. When in the face of it, you're not going to turn down $10 million.
Hold on. Movies that came out in 1999. The Matrix. Fight Club. American Beauty. This one I don't want to read out, but it's Star Wars Episode One. The Green Mile. American Pie. It's The Sixth Sense. Office Space. Your favorite, Chad. The Mummy.
Oh, love The Mummy.
Boondock Saints. There's just so many good movies.
Brendan Fraser made a better movie in 1999 than Will Smith did.
Yes, he did, actually. Austin Powers. Yeah, no, it's ranked 29th best movie that came out in 1999.
I'm surprised.
it's right before The Blair Witch Project.
Oh, I love The Blair Witch Project.
The production budget for The Matrix was $63 million.
Yeah, that's including cast salaries, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's what I'm saying. So $170 million, where do you think most of the $170 million went? It went to cast salaries.
$50 million
Will Smith
went to
asked
Smith.
For $100 million for that dick shot. It's like, it's going to cost you $2 million to have me, $100 million if you want me to hang some neck.
He probably got paid four times as much to be in Wild Wild West as if he would have been in The Matrix.
Yeah, probably, but most likely. The Matrix would have launched his career so much more than this movie.
Not really.
I don't
How much
so.
More
long
Look what it did for Keanu Reeves.
No, look what Will or
have
Keanu
you seen
Reeves
Constantine?
Did.
Did you see the
yes,
lake house?
I have. Yeah, the lake house. The Replacements.
I will give you that. Keanu Reeves hasn't done shit since, but that was probably more due to the other Matrix movies because they were so bad.
You know, I heard he lives like really like. Low key,
he's really sad.
It's because his dead brother.
I just saw his video with him on the subway where he gave up his seat to the woman.
Why would he be on the subway? He should be on his own subway. Do you think the train? What is it? The train man was taking him somewhere.
The train man.
Was that his name in the movies?
I don't fucking know.
The Matrix movies.
No.
The conductor.
No, the key maker? The Merovingian?
No, the guy on the train.
The conductor.
I don't remember the train. Yeah. That was in one of the second or third movies.
Yeah, which were awful.
Yeah, I don't remember those.
Except for the little
I pretend
robot
those never existed.
Got to ride around, and that was cool. Knuckle up. That's what I say to your mom sometimes.
I try to forget about the...
Will Smith was also in Hancock. I don't know if you guys...
Hancock? I liked Hancock.
I did, too. I think that was one of his better ones.
Hitch. It was a different aspect on superheroes.
He had Hitch, too. Like, he's done a lot more than Keanu did.
It's sad Hitch. That we're grasping for movies of his that we enjoyed, and we have to cite Hancock.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, he has a bunch of movies.
None of them were good.
He's done better movies...
What about the legend of Beggar Vance?
Like what? No, we were just saying he didn't do any good movies. He did Independence Day and like Hitch, and which I don't like more than any Keanu Reeves movie.
And Jeff Goldblum made Independence Day. I agree.
So it says that it basically estimates that he made about $20 million per movie when he made The Legend of Beggar Vance, Ali, and Wild Wild West.
He deserved more for Ali and less for the other two.
You guys are forgetting about Keanu Reeves' best movie ever made, though.
Lake House, I already mentioned it.
Hardball.
No, that's the one I was doing. We're not replacements. I was thinking about Hardball.
I fucking love that movie,
He's
too.
In both.
Of course you do. You love Rudy, though, so.
Yeah. He's the best movie ever.
Whoa. Wow.
I think we all know
Get
that
out
Highlander
of here with
is
that
best
shit.
Movie ever. Ugh. It won an Oscar for the best movie ever.
Will Smith didn't make Speed,
Academy
that's for fucking sure.
Thank you. Same thing.
Anybody got anything else before we're done with this piece of crap?
We can rate it, I think.
Yeah, I think so, maybe. We'll start with the Todd there.
I had no problems with this movie. I would say like a good, I'd give it an 8.
An 8?
Well, out of all the other shitty.
8 out of 10?
Out of all the other shitty movies we've seen, I think that this is my favorite out of all the other ones.
What is wrong with you?
You know God hates you, right?
Get out of here.
That's why he's Catholic.
I was waiting for it.
Okay, Zach.
I give this like a 4 plus.
4 plus, huh?
Yeah. Really?
We're throwing pluses at it now?
It's that's like my baseball scout thing. Okay. You know?
Gotcha.
4 plus. Because it's not quite Super Mario Brothers or Batman and Robin, but it was fucking awful.
It was close.
So 4 plus.
Gilbert?
I gave it a 7. I enjoyed it.
7?
Yeah, I enjoyed all the stupid puns. I really liked
it. Did you and Todd give each other handies while you were watching this? Or?
No, he just gave me the handies.
Oh, gotcha.
It was because he watched Solaris at the same time.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
Fucking A.
That was a little selfish of you, just so you know.
It was an angry handy. I couldn't reciprocate that.
Dry?
I mean, you could have.
Of course.
Okay.
What other handy is there?
They're all angry, especially when I'm behind the wheel. And I mean driving. Yeah. I'm a multitasker.
And you like to give hand jobs.
Yeah.
Both of those.
Yeah. Okay. I would probably give it a 6. It was short, which I enjoyed.
Yep.
That was nice.
It was short enough.
It was entertaining, but it was no FDR, American Badass. Well, the first 30 minutes of FDR, American Badass, it wasn't quite up to that standard.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it was all right.
When I compare this to, like, Deep Blue Sea, like, it's fucking garbage.
No,
I'd
put
much
it
rather
there
watch
with,
Deep Blue Sea.
I don't agree with you on that.
I'd put it there with Deep Blue Sea.
It was good, but
like, I found moments of enjoyment out of Deep Blue Sea.
I found enjoyment in this.
I didn't enjoy any of this movie.
There were some good puns. I like the puns.
Yeah. Taylor liked the dick.
Yeah, yeah. That's
cool.
Oh, now
that
I know it's there, I gotta rewatch. Freeze frame, rewind. Freeze frame.
I sent you a picture. You're good. Luckily, it's within like the first 2 minutes of the movie, yeah. So you don't have to watch that much.
Chad,
For me, I would probably give this movie a hard 7.
Hard 7.
Hard 7.
Not that soft 7. But
no,
the hard
no,
one.
No, soft. Hard.
Compared to what?
Huh?
Compared to something.
Hmm. Which is better than Mario.
Well, yeah.
It's
obviously.
Most movies
it's
are.
It's probably about on par with Deep Blue Sea for me. But yeah, right, but yeah. Our Mario ratings were like on average 3 points below that.
Yeah.
I don't feel like they were that low. I don't know the mind.
They
was.
Were. We
yeah,
pretty
no,
much
gave it like
everyone
a 3.
Was like 3-4 yeah. For Mario and Batman and all those awful movies. We watched a lot really bad back to back.
I enjoyed Batman. It was just so bad.
What's wrong with you?
So bad.
I'll give it a solid 5.
Okay.
It was mid range. Like there was a couple of random spots that I was like, ah, and then I moved on with it. I mean, the good part of it was only 1 hour and 46 minutes long.
Yeah.
Unlike the rest of the ones that we've been doing lately that have been 2+ hours that I'm just wanting to punch everyone around me while I'm watching them.
Yeah. Anybody know how long the movie next week's gonna be?
It's over 2.
Oh.
I'm pretty sure.
And you're going to see it twice.
Yeah, because you're a little bitch. You're going to see it twice.
And you're going to see it twice.
I
just
agree,
so everyone,
I would take someone to see it.
Just so everyone knows, we are going to be reviewing 50 Shades of Grey live from the theater next week.
Live from the theater?
By yes. Live from the theater,
we just
he means we're
we
going to watch
computers
it.
And microphones and soundboards.
Yes.
Don't mind us.
We set up our own land. I don't give a fuck about those bitches in the theater. Fucking podcast, bitch. Get off my dick.
I've actually heard people say that they're going to go back and see it because they liked it so much.
I've heard that they're stupid, and they should be taken to Utah and put in front of the firing squad that they just reinstated.
Why? Okay.
What? What?
Yeah, you didn't hear about that? I think
no.
It was Utah. Was it Utah?
I don't know what you're
yeah,
talking
they
about.
Voted to bring back a firing squad.
I'm moving.
Because it costs too much money to do other forms of death penalty.
You know what costs more than a less than a bunch of bullets? One bullet.
Yeah, I don't really get the whole firing squad
style.
Thing.
Yeah.
I don't know why they
yeah,
do
the
it that way.
The firing squad's done so that you don't know who killed him.
Well, all right. But what if everyone gets the shot?
Well, that's the point.
I feel like we are at a point where we could just, you know, set it on a timer. Yeah, like make a machine that shoots someone for us.
Yeah, that's true.
Okay, so
that took a dark turn.
Yep. things that we're going to be working on later on.
So,
something we can sell Utah to kill people with.
Yep.
That's how we'll make my millions.
So, I was watching TV, and
you don't say.
Well, I actually don't watch TV that
Let
often.
Me guess, you were snacking.
No.
At the time.
Is this in between ship breaks?
Yes, in between ship breaks. No, I generally don't watch TV, so I don't
Before
ever see
or after masturbation?
Oh, it was during.
All right.
It's There's always no during. Doubt about
yeah, that never stops.
But I saw the trailer for The Duff, and I feel like this movie is going to be really offensive to people, because Duff stands for Designated Ugly Fat Friend, and it's about May fucking Whitman. Jesus Christ. May Whitman.
Which one of you is it?
Go fuck yourself.
It's either you or you.
I don't care.
All right.
But anyways, Designated Ugly Fat Friend. Mae Whitman, she's not that fat, and she's not that ugly. It's also got the dude from 1600 Penn in it.
Josh Gad.
No, not Josh Gad. I don't know if Josh Gad is in it or
not. You're talking about the boyfriend.
The younger dude, yeah. Yeah, the one that got her pregnant. But anyways, it just looks like super fucked up. Like, I'm like surprised that... Like, with how butthurt everyone gets over the dumbest shit these days, it's kind of strange.
How'd the movies F do last week standards. There, Tanner?
What's that?
How'd the movies do last week?
I'm
assuming Fifty
see.
Shades took the cake there.
I don't know box office, because I wrote all this up last night. Kingsman actually got really good ratings.
Yeah, I've been wanting to see the shit out of that.
I've been wanting to see that, too.
It got a 71 critic rating, 89% user rating on Rotten Tomatoes. 50 Shades of Grey actually got a 26% critic rating and a 50% user rating, but it probably made more, I would guess.
Everything I read about 50 Shades of Grey said that if you haven't read the book, it's one of the worst movies you'll ever see.
All right, I haven't read the book.
I've read the book, and I thought the book was one of the worst things I've ever read in my life, so I'm anticipating it's probably going to be one of the worst movies ever. Won't be Solaris, but it's going to be down there.
So, upcoming, one movie that I've been excited to see, which I'm...
Hot Tub
feeling,
Time Machine 2?
Yeah, I'm going to be let down, but Hot Tub Time Machine 2. I loved Hot Tub
if
Time Machine.
If it's not about the Cincinnati trip they hinted about in the first movie, I'm going to be very disappointed. They need to include it.
They can't include it because John Cusack's not in it.
I think that they can at this point because he's not in it.
I think they're saving it for me. I think they're saving it for 3. It's not a deal breaker because he didn't really do anything in the first movie.
Yeah, I mean,
what the fuck did he do?
He
got a divorce.
He was a main port.
He got a divorce.
Yeah.
He cried. He fucked around with Lizzie Kaplan, which I'm a little jelly of. But that's about it. That's about it.
He didn't add anything.
Yeah, he got stabbed with a fork. He's a little bitch.
They're going to replace him with, oh, God, what's the dorky kid?
Has John Cusack been in a movie and not been a bitch? Is there one movie that you can name that he's been in that he's not been a giant
2012?
Bitch? 2012? Yes. Giant bitch.
Straight badass.
Serendipity. Giant bitch.
Whoa.
Say
whoa,
anything.
Whoa.
Don't say things you
giant
can't take
bitch.
Back.
No, I'm not saying the movie.
You bite your fucking tongue.
I'm not saying the movie was bad. Okay. I'm saying he was a giant bitch in the movie. Was he not?
That's pretty much the role he played.
That's what
hero.
I'm saying. That's
if
the I, only role that he's ever played.
If I have to watch a romantic comedy, he better fucking be in it.
No, I disagree.
Yes. I'd take B-Coops over him.
Are you fucking kidding me?
You don't like
Ryan Reynolds.
I like
either or.
Oh, Ryan Reynolds.
Ooh. Ryan Reynolds.
No, you don't say a fucking
die.
Word right
you
now.
You better watch
fuck
yourself.
Already. Fuck Ryan Reynolds.
John
Cusack
problems.
Is the unsung awkward hero.
No.
No, he's not.
No.
That's fucking eight.
A
yeah, he is.
Bitch.
He's not unsung because it's the same character in every goddamn movie.
Got a point there.
Don't matter. His
what's his face, Sarah?
Good. Say anything.
Michael
Sarah.
I love Michael Sarah. He's so fucking awkward.
I want to just punch him right in the balls.
I do too. Like this is the end was probably my favorite Michael Cera role ever.
When
he where
blows
he played
the
himself.
Coke in the club in his face. That's hilarious.
Want a sippy? A little sippy? A little sippy at my Capri Sun?
Slaps Rihanna on the ass.
Oh my gosh. Apparently that was
say
real.
You wouldn't do that.
Apparently that was real. Like he's like, I'm really going to slap your ass. She's like, well, I'm really going to punch you in the face. He's like, okay. And apparently they did it like 6 times.
Probably worth it.
Say you wouldn't slap Rihanna.
Oh, no.
Ass.
Oh, I
that.
Would. I mean, I think she
Chris
would just
Brown
be
did.
Happy
yeah.
that it's
and a
not
lot of
her
other
face.
Places.
Yeah.
Yeah. She punched me. She'd, you know, she'd feel that wrath. Real fucking quick.
Are you guys ready for the hypothetical?
What else is coming? Yeah, sure.
I mean, that's all that's coming out this weekend.
Yeah.
Too. I mean, there's
that McFarlane, whatever.
I didn't
shut
even
up.
See that.
I saw a preview for it a while back. I barely remember it.
It's the Disney feel-good movie of the year.
Thanks for that.
Thank you.
What?
Something about
I do
want to
see that new Disney movie that's coming out. The one where with Clooney.
Tomorrowland.
Tomorrowland.
That one's still a couple.
It looks good.
Months out.
Did you guys hear that Big Hero 6 actually has made its their top three grossing films of all time?
It's
now.
A good movie.
The anime. It's great.
Yeah, it was
but it's
very
it's
good.
Like Lion King and Frozen, and then Big Hero 6.
Why
How
Frozen?
Did Frozen
what
not
the fuck?
Beat out Lion King?
Because nothing's gonna touch Lion
why
King.
I don't know.
So
if it might have.
Why do people like Frozen so much? I've never seen it. I don't want to see it.
It's
like
good.
It's
everything
like
I've
modern.
You have
it's
go.
A return
it.
To
let
that old formula that they had, kind of the old musical animated crap.
I don't get it.
I saw it. It wasn't great.
Speaking,
I enjoyed Frozen.
Then again, I'm a grown ass man, so it's not. I'm not exactly the demographic.
Speaking of Disney, did we talk about the Beauty and the Beast remake?
Oh, with
yeah, we did.
Emma Watson.
Yeah, we had a conversation.
Emma Watson and Ryan Reynolds.
And who?
Ryan Reynolds is gonna play Beast.
Oh, you don't say. I'm watching it.
So
fucking Ryan Reynolds.
Looking at Disney movies.
This would be some sexy ass babies. I would fuck their babies.
Oh my God!
What?
You're not supposed to say things like that.
What?
Why would you fuck babies?
They're both beautiful people. They're
you don't have to fuck their baby. You
I would
wait.
Well, I would.
If no, anyone, if anyone is listening to this, this was recorded at Tanner's house on Tanner's computer. I'm just saying.
You got some stuff you don't want people
don't
looking for?
I don't know. I go
so
on 4chan
gonna,
just like the best
gonna,
of us.
We're going to quote Tanner before the show. What breaks when you give it to a 2-year-old?
Oh.
Hips.
My
hips.
Heart.
Oh.
Frozen is the highest grossing animated film.
I can't believe.
No, Toy Story 3 is. Just found it. Toy Story 3, $415 million.
Disney's Oscar-winning Frozen has become the top grossing animated film of all time, surpassing the $1.063 billion earned. By fellow Toy Story Pixar
Toy Story
title,
3.
Toy Story 3.
Did any of you guys watch Toy Story 3?
No.
I did depressing not. I heard it's terrible. Depressing.
I don't even
okay.
think I watched Toy Story 2.
Did you guys cry?
No.
Oh my
no.
God, you're
no,
good.
I didn't.
Neither
no,
did I. Did.
It's not cast, it's not Castaway.
I didn't cry during Toy Story 3 at all.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Just going to let it go.
All right.
Hypothetical
let
for
rule number
this
two.
Evening. Here you go. If you could learn any one skill in the world without trying, which would you pick and why?
Okay, are we talking about real skills?
Yeah, real skills.
Mm. No, I want to learn kung fu.
Is that what? Because actually, it says in here like the Matrix learning style.
I know that was
that's
what
a, yeah.
Fun
I mean, I just took that out of there because we've been talking about the Matrix so damn much this whole episode that I was gonna go without it. But any skill, which would you pick and why?
You go first.
I want to learn how to turn. I want to learn how to build a water powered car.
I don't think that's a
a boat. I don't.
No, 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 no.
I don't think that's a skill.
Like a carburetor that'll run on water.
That's just yeah.
Is your carburating?
Yeah, I want it to carburate water.
I don't think that's a skill though.
Shut up, bitch. Panda says it's a skill. It's a fucking skill. I don't know what that means. But fuck
I don't
you.
Either. I would. I think mine would be the leaning sword, something of either being able to charm someone, like, you know, you have those, like, actual people in the world that have learned how to charm or persuade people
sounds
so
like
well.
Sounds like you want AIDS.
That doesn't, what?
No.
That doesn't sound
I'm
like
pretty
AIDS
sure
at all.
It sounds like you want AIDS on
I
your
don't,
face.
I don't see how that makes sense at all.
I mean, are you talking
explain,
about,
no,
like,
hold on, stop. Explain your explain your sentence right now. Why does it sound
I
like
I'm
have
Chad,
a, I want AIDS?
I'm Sir Chadline. I don't have to fucking explain a goddamn thing.
I like that save there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Like seducing people? Or just like...
Like not seducing, but being able to persuade them to do whatever I want.
It's called a boob job. I mean, that's how
I mean,
those
if that's,
work.
If that's what I got to do, that's what I got to do.
Yeah.
I'll give it you my titties say, for free. I mean...
I don't think your titties are seducing
that's enough
anyone.
For you to have a D cup and him to have a D cup.
Todd, you got one?
I'm still thinking. Like,
good luck with that.
Keep pass.
I wanna cleanse the Catholic Church of pedophiles.
That's not a skill.
That's not a skill anyone
bullshit.
Has. Bullshit.
Neither
up
is
skill.
Fucking vampire hunting. People do it.
This needs this needs to be achievable.
Yeah.
I wanna learn to hunt vampires. Where the fuck is Van Helsing at?
And that's how the Catholic
hunt
Church
vampires
got
or
dissolved.
Werewolves.
Van Helsing hunt on
yeah, both.
Dracula.
No, yeah, he hunted vampires and werewolves, didn't he?
No, I don't think he went.
I'm pretty sure Hugh Jackman.
Hit
pretty
both. Sure he was a werewolf.
Oh, maybe that's what it was.
Yeah, but that's
yeah, so
in real life. Have you seen him? He's a hairy man.
I agree.
Zach, what do you think?
I've always kind of wanted to learn spelunking.
I'll show asshole spelunking or like actual cave diving?
Like actual.
It's just called spelunking. It's just called going head first into a cave. There's no skill there. It's
definitely
just
a skill.
Around.
You go in there without knowing how to spelunk, and we'll see how you come out.
Hopefully with AIDS.
I've been
on
crawling
face.
For
why
a long time.
Have
I'm
AIDS
fine.
On their face?
Why not?
I think you know why not.
No, I don't.
Nobody wants that.
Fucking Jumanji.
What you got?
I'm still thinking. Come back to me.
I want to learn how to turn board games into Jumanji.
That's not a skill.
Like real life Jumanji.
You don't want to do that. You end up hanging yourself. It's depressing.
Oh my God. He didn't learn. He was just involved in the game.
I've got two people holding their face.
Was that a square?
Okay?
Was
that
a
line? Did I cross it?
Was that a square on the Jumanji board? Like once you get to a certain age, you have to do it.
Yeah.
Don't be a bitch.
It's before the monkey.
We went through a phase. There was like a
David
4 or 5 episode phase where we made tons of hanging jokes.
Yeah.
We like moved past it, but apparently we're back.
We're back. Full circle.
Right back.
Like
do you think that Robin Williams no-balls David Carradine and, you know, that's what actually happened? Oh, he was just following up on a no-balls.
I think is no-balls like a common term? Is that just us?
I don't know if anybody
plays the game.
Yeah, the game of no-balls is if you no-ball someone and they do it, then you have to do it too.
Twice.
Yeah. No, you don't have to do it twice. You only have to do it once because you can't hang yourself twice. It only happens once.
If you're good, you can.
Maybe if you fail. If you fail the first time. I think what I would go for, hands-free
smelling.
Masturbation.
Hands.
Done.
Oh. You wouldn't just teach yourself to suck your own dick?
Multitasking. I'm for it.
You ever seen those people that do that?
What?
Like their tantric shit where they just sit there and they're like, you know, they go into it.
Yeah.
And do you think it's real?
I don't know. I
guess. Always wondered that too.
On an episode of Marin.
I've never watched Marin.
Pretty good.
Yeah, I heard Connor Oberst was on there today.
Yeah.
Old Red Eyes piece.
Todd?
I think I have all the skills that I need in life. So I can't think of anything.
Do you want us to comment on that?
As someone who has been around for a while, you don't.
Just fucking let me have this
you
one.
You don't have most of the skills you need.
Just move along and let me have this one.
Are you going to cry? You sound like you're about to cry.
Like you wouldn't want to like be a sports star? Or, I mean, there's all kinds of skills
I don't think
in
that's
the world.
Happening with me.
So can you give us a list of all the skills you need to survive in the world?
I take it back. I've changed mine.
No, you're stuck with making yourself come without touching yourself. That's how this works.
I once saw a guy who could pee out of the moonroof of his car or the sunroof. He would just sit in the driver's seat, whip it out, piss straight up, and it would go the sunroof.
The yeah, but the bottom of the stream's not
yeah,
like when
no,
you're done.
You piss on yourself, no matter what.
There's no easy
there's
way to do
that.
There's
always a little dribble. I mean, so
that's a lot of dribble.
Yeah, that's more than getting, a little dribble.
You're getting piss on your face every
yeah,
time.
I really think you need to rethink this. I really think you need to rethink
a bitch
this. Yeah,
last little bit of stream.
Yeah, Isaac Newton didn't invent gravity for you to be able to piss out of the moon.
He invented gravity.
He invented fucking gravity.
He did not.
Someone asked him this question, and he said, I want to invent gravity. And you know what? He fucking did.
He did not.
He fucking did.
That's not how that worked.
I'm pretty sure it is.
Yeah.
That's going to be a movie one day.
Yeah. Back in 1994.
What?
When he invented gravity.
Copernicus changed the solar system.
Yes, he
possibly
did.
The universe.
Then
I
him
think Isaac Newton can invent gravity.
Yeah. They were best friends. Same timesies.
I'll give you that he discovered it. He didn't invent it.
Motherfucker invented goddamn gravity.
Ben Franklin invented electricity, too.
Sure.
I believe that.
Yeah, he put a key on a
actually
kite or some shit like
right?
that. Put a key on a kite.
Gilbert, it's on you. Since Todd has all the life skills he's going to
yeah,
need.
Yeah, fucking Todd.
I'd be like Taken, the dude from Taken. And just go around and...
Do you want to
that's
fucking
a specific
murder people?
Set of skills.
Yeah.
That's not one skill.
That's not one skill. You get one skill.
No,
that he
no.
Has.
Let's just give it to him. We'll just give it to him.
We're gonna the ability to make a lot of money off of really shitty productions. It's a good skill.
That's a good skill.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
I want to have the skills of Tom Brady and win 4 Super Bowls.
But you'd have to cheat to win them.
Yep.
When's the last time your team won a Super Bowl?
When's the last time your team was in the Super Bowl?
When's the last time you made the playoffs?
Playoffs?
Enough said.
5 years ago.
5 centuries ago.
Anyways,
So next week we've got a group of guys that's going to go into a movie theater, probably
pants off.
It's going to get real weird.
We got a bunch of guys that's going to go see 50 Shades of Grey together.
If we get one person to share this post on Facebook, Tanner is going to dress up as the Gimp from
we'll take pictures.
Tanner is going to dress up as the Gimp from Pulp Fiction in the pawn shop scene. And he's going to go see the movie like that with a ball gag in his mouth if we get a share.
One share? No.
One share from
someone we don't know.
That's fine.
Fuck
no,
that.
We can do two.
We'll do two shares.
No.
Come on. It's not going to happen. Nobody shares
it. Can't be anybody at this table.
Yeah.
No.
He said no one we know.
Yeah. No one we know.
No one. Yeah, that, I think that's good.
That's
five.
Fair.
No.
Don't.
Three. Don't
two.
Be a pussy.
Three. We'll do three.
Three.
Come on. We're really pushing it with three here. This has to be done. We're doing it on Sunday, the whatever day Sunday is.
16th. Is it?
Yeah, it's the 22nd.
All right. Yeah, all right.
February 22nd. If we get three shares.
Three likes and shares.
Three likes on the Facebook and shares. We'll take pictures of him dressing up as the Gimp and going with a bunch of dudes to see 50 Shades of Grey.
Oh, I don't know who's that. Who gets the worst deal on that? Tanner, who's
anyone who's looking
or
at
us?
The picture. And I'm going to be doing very in-depth Facebook research on any of these likes that we get. I'm going to look up genealogies. I'm going to be visiting people's houses. And
by
just,
the way.
I'm going to call in favors, and I'm going to make sure they're at least six removed.
All right, whatever.
For the good of the show.
Yeah.
For the good of the show.
And you know what? I would say, what's next episode? 20?
20.
Next
this 20? Will be the 20th.
I would say on the 20th episode, we'll also give away a couple shirts.
Maybe.
Maybe.
We've been trying to give away shirts for the last 10 episodes.
Yeah, that's true. Like the page.
Again.
Share the post.
Nolan.
We still got the fucking calendar.
No, fuck Nolan. We're done with Nolan. Moving on. The calendar's mine. I'm calling
it.
Mike tried to take the calendar today.
Yeah.
I had to stop him for the sake of Nolan.
I'm just saying. I even came up with the idea of making a Facebook account that was Nolan.
To take it. Yeah.
Anyways,
you just say, no, I'll come by and pick it up. Thanks, guys. Come by and pick it up. Anyway.
So that's our podcast.
Yep. Yeah.
Answer the question.
Website.
Ask us questions.
Website. Facebook.
If there's a movie you want us to review.
We've got a list going.
Leave it on the Facebook. Yeah, but yours will take precedence.
Yeah, we'll give you priority.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Anyone except for Solaris.
As long as it's not gay porn, I'm down.
Hey, I'll watch some gay porn. Please.
Huh? If someone
I said vote for Solaris.
Solaris is not going to happen.
If someone likes us on Facebook and shares it, I'll watch Solaris.
I won't. I will skip that podcast, but to each their own.
Or like we'll just have Gilbert do a solo episode.
Yes, he will do an episode.
Would you?
It'll just be 50.
I'll do
it'll be 53 minutes of Gilbert talking about Solaris.
I'm down.
I'm not.
I won't
that
be on
the
it,
least,
but I'll watch.
That will be the least listened to episode.
Slobbering all over George Clooney's dick.
Probably wouldn't be the first.
You can get Matt Wright on here with you. The only person that likes Solaris. He's probably the only person I've ever met that likes that movie.
Yeah
that's true. Okay.
So anything else? I guess we're done.
Yeah. Cool. Check us out. Facebook, Reddit,
Twitter,
YouTube, all that shit.
GhostRide.com.
Facebook.
Fuck your mothers.
We're on Reddit?
Yeah, we're on Reddit.
We've got our own subreddit.
Should I get on there? I'm like,
yeah.
Should I like be active in there?
I don't know. There's not
we're not that active. All of our episodes are posted there.
Yeah, so. It's automatically posted.
I don't know.
Cool.
Well, see you guys.
Catch you guys next
like
week.
Like I was saying, fuck your mother. Have a good
day. Bye.